power elite. Very simple. Why power elite? Rejecting Marxism. Marx predicted that with the rise of communism, there will be no elites, as there is a communally owned property with absolute equality. But C.W. Mill says that in every known society, there will be only presence of domination by few, he calls as power elite. Contradicting to Pareto, who spoke about the psychological traits of the elites, C.W. Mill says, power is institutional, power is not individual. There are three key institutions in America having command posts. Those who occupy this command post, they are called as power elite. These three key institutions are MNC, military, government. How they are having similarity of social background? All are Protestants. All are living in the west part of America. All belong to the same schools or college. All have cultural symbols. So they have unity of interest. And these power elites, they exercise power which is unaccountable. And they are involving in the self-aggrandizement of power. They take decisions for which they are not accountable. Key decisions like the Hiroshima or Nagasaki bomb was taken by them. They are the one who dictate people, who dictate masses what to think, what to feel and how to act. They use various instruments of psychic manipulation to manipulate the mind of the people. So, the presence of power light is an existential reality even in a democracy. C.W. Mill identifies how even in a democracy like America, power is not decentralized. It is only concentrated in the hands of few power elites. Lupton and Shirley, in their kinship diagram, found that how in Britain, the CEOs of all important banks, insurance companies, they are all related to each other. Speaking about elite self-recruitment, Shirley and Lupton, L-U-P-T-O-N, Shirley and Lupton, in their kinship diagram study, they found how top CEOs in Britain are belonging to the same family, either matrimonial or they have either conjugal bond or consanguineal bond, relatives of marriage or relatives of blood. So this speaks about the myth of democracy. This speaks about the myth of democracy. America professes equality but practices inequality. America is practicing inequality but professing democracy. So no society is perfectly open. No society is perfectly closed. Inequality appears in different societies which are different only in time and space. Inequality appears in different societies which are distinct only in terms of degrees rather than kind. So, no society is equalitarian society. No society is highly inequalitarian society. Inequality is a reality in every known society. Only the form and the content of inequality varies, but inequality stays in all society, making poverty and inequality an acceptable form of differences. Right? So, no communism can help you in equality. There may be political equality in communism, but there may be economic equality in communism, but there will be present political equality. So, inequality possibility is very, the possibility of inequality is only a probability and not certainty. Right? So, Sivarajavel is highly critical of Marxian theory, which is predicting perfect equality.